I've got something stuck in my throat, but I'm going to try and do this video without coughing or gagging. Also, I moved my mic, so I think videos should be more clear. Like, the way I sound in videos should be way more clear than they have been in the past. So, we're going to find out. But in this video, I'm going to talk about a scene from a movie, like I do in a lot of these videos lately, that honestly freaked me out. Now, that's gratuitous because a lot of these movies and scenes I've talked about freak me out. But this is another one to add on to that pile of movies and scenes that have freaked me out. And that, of course, is the scene from The Hobbit to the Desolation of Smaug, or however you pronounce his name. And it is the spider scene. That's right. We're doing another spider-themed video like I've done many times before. Why? Because they creep me out. They make for good stories to do videos on. So this happened in 2013. I was in eighth grade. My older brother, who was a senior at this point, comes to my room and he says, "We're gonna go see The Hobbit, the second one." And I haven't seen the first one. I haven't seen any of the Lord of the Rings. I hadn't seen the first Hobbit movie. And basically I was like, no, I'm not gonna go. I don't wanna go. I want to stay here and play Minecraft. But he ended up convincing me to go, so I went. And throughout the whole movie, really Middle Earth, that kind of stuff wasn't really my cup of tea. I'm into The Hobbit, Lord of the Rings now. Not as much as I am in other things like Star Wars and Marvel. Not too much into it, but I can still enjoy it. But back then, I really didn't. I remember sitting in the theater and just kind of like, I was kind of bored. It was just me and my brother, and really I just wasn't into it at all. And about halfway through the movie, the Hobbits, Bilbo and co., decide they need to travel through this spooky ass forest, and they're like, we're gonna go in here because this is where we need to go to get where we're going. I honestly forget where they're going. They're going to like Smaug's castle or something. But they get into this forest and they don't know where they're at, and they're like, okay, we need to know where we're at. So Bilbo's like, I'm gonna go to the top of this very tall tree up here and I'm gonna go see what I can see. So he goes up there, peeks above, sees this beautiful sunset, this beautiful like just view. And he's like, oh, I see it. And he yells down to the rest of the Hobbits. He goes, I see it, everybody. Whatever. And yeah, no one responds. Nobody responds to him. And he's like, oh, that's weird. And then he slips. And he's like, oh, shit, I'm going down. He slips and he falls. And he ends up in a giant spider web. And this is at the point in the movie where I'm going from this to this. Literally, I was sitting like that. I was like, oh, what's going on here? No one told me there were spiders in this movie. What's going on? And Bilbo kind of sees something ruffling around the web, and he peeks, like, he gets a closer look, and this happens. I really want to point out, actually, watching that scene again, is Bilbo comes face to face with that spider first. Like, they lock eyes, they look at each other. It's not until the spider roars that he actually gets scared. That's pretty fucking brave, in my opinion, because honestly, only if I'm in a spider web, I'm freaking out. He's sitting there and he's just. And then the spider's like, ah! And he's like, ah! And he falls, and then he gets wrapped up, and, you know, he ends up escaping. But that had me, like, terrified in the theater. I think that's the most scared I've been in a theater in my life, honestly. I take that back. The most scared I've been in the theater was watching The Nun in 2018. I've talked about that a few times on the channel. The Nun is, like, my worst fear. Every time I mention it, I have to look around and make sure she's not going to appear. But it's actually my worst fear, honestly. But before that, this movie, that scene, the most scared I've ever been in the theater. It was terrifying. So the way they make the spiders sound, when Bilbo puts on the ring, he can hear the spiders. He can hear them talk, and the voice they use for the spiders just works. It works. The best I can compare it to is like 1980s Saw Scream, kind of that higher pitched, raspy kind of voice. That's kind of what I would compare it to, and it works. It really works. There are only like two ways a spider can sound if it spoke English, and it's gonna be spiders from this movie and the spider from Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. It's gonna sound like one of those two. That if spiders could speak in English, that's how they would sound, honestly. But this scene just really took me out. Like, I was invested. Like afterwards, like obviously Bilbo and the Hobbits escape, and then the elves come in and help them escape, and it's a really cool kind of like fight. And Bilbo, like, you know, uses the ring to go invisible and, you know, trick a spider and, like, fucking kill it. And it's really cool. Creepy as hell, though. It's really creepy. I'm gonna go ahead and play a snippet of how the spiders actually sound. I feel like I need to back up just how much this voice they chose actually works for these spiders. It's creepy. If spiders spoke English, like if we could understand them, that's how they would sound. I guarantee it. I don't know. It's so creepy. And then the last one that comes in like crawls over Bilbo and it like hits the really long note where it's like feast. Oh man, that's terrifying, dude. It's insanely terrifying. It was actually after that scene. My brother and I got home from the theater, and he's telling the story back to my other brothers and the rest of my family. He goes, "Oh, well, that scene, that got Ryan poked up in that movie. You know, it was so funny to watch his reaction." It's not like I like gave any more of a reaction, and just, I was more so just like, when I was watching the movie, I was like, "Oh my god!" I went from being bored to invested. I was like, "All right, well, I didn't know spiders would hear it, so let's see what happens." And that happens, and it was terrifying. But it was pointed out to me that if I wanted to see something even creepier than the spiders in Lord of the Rings or in The Hobbit, then I needed to try out Shelob in Lord of the Rings. And I did. Looked it up. I looked up Lord of the Rings, Shelob. And oh my god. It's actually a little bit less creepy, I think, than this scene in The Hobbit. I don't know. Maybe just because Sam comes in and kicks Shelob's ass and it's a really fucking cool fight scene. I mean, I gotta give it to Sam. He sees his friend getting wrapped up into a web by a giant spider and literally just like steps in and he's like, "All right, bitch, let's fucking go." And he fucking fights. He goes toe to toe, literally toe to toe because he's barefoot. And he like fights a giant spider like and defeats it. He doesn't kill it, but he defeats it. And honestly, everyone needs a friend like Sam. Like if I'm getting wrapped up by a giant spider, which I hope does not happen, then I need a friend I can count on to rescue me, like Sam, because let's be real here. I mean, if I walk in and see my friend being wrapped up by a giant spider, I'm not stepping in and being like, "Let him go, you filth." I'm not. I don't think I could. I don't think I physically could. But Sam, on the other hand, is literally just like, "Let's go. You're going to try to take my friend? Nah, you don't get to do that." I just had to show that. Like, I can't imagine watching that in the theater and just seeing that and being creeped out by it. And then here comes Sam. And Sam just being like, "Fuck, dude, let's go. Like, what, one-on-one, man. 1v1, we're doing this right now." And then he ends up, like, beating him. Now, I don't know a lot about the Lord of the Rings lore, but apparently that little stone he's holding that glows helps him defeat Shelob, I think. I read it in a comment on this exact video when I watched it like 5 years ago that the glowy rock thing he's holding actually helps defeat Shelob. I don't know. If you know Lord of the Rings, like, well, any Lord of the Rings and Hobbit lore, feel free to comment it because I watch it, I just don't know a lot about it, and I feel kind of like an idiot calling it the glowing rock, which is basically what it is. But there's probably an actual name for it. But yeah, I just had to talk about this, well, both these scenes, because why not? I love doing videos where I talk about movie scenes, especially movie scenes that have, you know, scared me or creeped me out in some way. I really enjoy it. So if you guys enjoyed it as well, hopefully this new mic placement helps the video sound better, like my voice in the video sound better. Hopefully it does. Again, let me know in the comments how that sounds. If you watch my other videos, feel free to compare them. Bossy Atlanta, brand new one. Have a good day. Thanks for watching. And as always, stay awesome, everybody.